This is a development. I'm going to call this potentially a breakthrough on health care reform. Senator Schumer, leader of the Democrats in the Senate, has sent a letter to Mitch McConnell and other Republicans. He leads the Republican Party in the Senate. Senator Schumer wants to meet a bipartisan meeting on health care reform. Looks like movement of sorts. Alex Azar is with us, knows a thing or two about health care reform. I'm saying that this is a development. It's progress. It's a sign that they may be getting together about something or other on health care reform. You agree with this?
Stuart, I will believe it when I see it. Listen, if the Democrats were willing to work with Republicans to try to get to that 51 votes needed to pass health reform in the Senate, then yes, this is development. Because frankly, I don't know right now how the Republicans get a bill through the Senate between the conservative side and the more moderate side. I've been trying to figure this out. I don't know how you skin that cat. But if the Democrats come in and join up with the moderate Republicans...
Why would he want a meeting if he's going to block every suggestion at every possible turn? I mean, why not? If he wants to hold a meeting, and the letter suggests that he does, then presumably they've got something to talk about. They've got an offer maybe that he could make. And I'll agree with you on this and this and this if you don't do that. I mean, that's progress, isn't it?
Well, it very well could be. Let's see what happens in that meeting. At this point, frankly, some of the views of the more moderate Republicans are seeming a lot like more tinkering with the existing Obamacare than real structural underlying reform of it. And so there may actually be rapprochement there between the Democrats and moderate Republicans on this one. I don't know. We haven't ever seen anything like that in sort of the modern time with the Congress. So let's see.
Okay, I'm calling it progress, and you can abstain on that if you like. Right.
I'm just a hopeless cynic.
No, you're not, Alex, you're not. Now, top Trump officials, they're meeting at the White House today. The subject is drug prices and how to get them down. Now, A, can they get them down? And B, Alex, how do they do it?
So the first thing is the issue shouldn't be just to focus on drug prices. The issue is, what are people paying when they go to the pharmacy to get their drugs? Is it affordable to them there? List price, whatever else. The most important thing is, what's that patient paying when they go to the pharmacy? And I think there are some really good things they can do. The president has made clear he supports innovation on the one side, but he also wants to make drugs more affordable to people. I think a couple steps that they could be looking at. One is, I think he's going to tell his trade negotiators to get on Europe and get off the free ride on the investment in innovation. You know, they have such radical price controls over in Europe, and get on them for those unfair practices and see if we can get more investment from them in R&D and less of the burden being shouldered by U.S. citizens. We can increase generic and branded competition. Scott Gottlieb, our great new FDA commissioner, has already launched an initiative to get more generics approved, more branded drugs approved, so they're competing against each other, driving prices down, making things more affordable.
How about importing stuff from Canada?
Stuart, one of the best things in the American healthcare system is our closed distribution system. We have such tight control on product here in the United States. That's why when you walk into a Walgreens or a CVS, you know it's safe, it's authentic. This thing about importing drugs from Canada is a canard. These drugs are not American-produced drugs sitting in a Canadian retail pharmacy. These are often drugs coming from China or India or elsewhere that are just being transshipped through Canada into the United States. The administration, the public health officials have repeatedly found these are not safe. They can be no guarantee of safety there. Mm. The U.S. distribution system is a crown jewel. Let us not mess that up.
Okay. Oh, we will not mess that up. All right, Alex, thanks very much for joining us.